Excuse me. Chest infection. Not good. I've not been keeping well. Too many late nights, I think. I'll start off with an apology. I promised everybody a running video with my brand new HPI Jumpshot brushless against Matthew's ECX Ruckus brushless monster trucks. I am a man of my word, it will happen, but it can't just now. I'll show you why. I'll show you my HPI my jump shot. Well, yeah, it doesn't look as good as it did, I'll admit. A few rough edges. I'll get to this, but let me just give you some information first of all on the jump shot. In case, you know, you're looking at getting a monster truck in the future, you know, a basher or what have you. It is it has the potential, this truck, actually, really, to become not only one of the best monster truck, two-wheel drive monster truck 110s on the market for bashing, but just flat out one of the best two-wheel drive monster trucks. It has the potential to be a very, very good truck. In fact, a great truck. At the moment, though, it's not a great truck. At the moment, it's merely a good truck. And good isn't good enough. We'll talk about positives first. As a basher, it's pretty awesome, actually. We spoke about, earlier on in a previous video, we spoke about the flexible plastics at the front and how, you know, it would spring back in a crash rather than snap. That works perfectly well. The chassis itself, with all the aluminium parts, it's very strong. I've had no damage whatsoever, and I've had some pretty crazy tumbles. Head over heels, somersaults, and the sort of things that would turn my old glossy high roller into confetti. It shrugs them off. So yeah, as a basher, solid. It also handles very well. Despite the fact that we have these brilliant Pro-Line trenchers, which have massive amounts of grip and also side bite, the truck doesn't dig in traction roll at all. The shocks seem to be, although they look a bit pansy, the shocks are actually very well set up. I've had to add a little bit of preload, but that's because of the weight of this wheelie bar. It jumps, I've only done one or two jumps on a speed bump, but I'm not taking it to BMX track or anything yet because it's broken, obviously. But it looks like it lands very well, it's nice and neutral in the air, and yeah, it has potential. So let's get to the bad parts. The shell is weak. The shell is, I know you'll see a few videos on YouTube already, and the truck's only been about like a month or something. People running it with the standard brush system, and the shells are splitting. As you can see, mine has been taped many times and glued because it does. Yeah, it splits quite easily. So the shell really should be tougher than it is. And the main reason here, the main problem I have, I don't know if the gear is in here. Is it? Here it is. That's the reason my truck is off the road. That is a idler gear, and it's plastic. Now, I know plastic idler gears are in several models nowadays, and you get strong enough plastics that can withstand reasonable amounts of power. Certainly enough to survive 4,600 kV two cell, which is what this is running. Unfortunately, this idler gear is too soft. It's rubbish, and I didn't even get one battery pack out of it before it failed. So that's not good. I phoned the HPI, and well, they're releasing a brushless version of the jump shot at some point, and it'll have aluminium parts rather than the plastic parts in the gearbox, which will be great. I just need to wait. I could rebuild it and get some plastic idler gears and stuff, but frankly, I don't want to. I'm not interested in having a truck that will run for, I mean, I could adjust the slipper clutch and, you know, get a little bit more compliant and take a little bit of the load off that, but I could never trust it. That was one of the reasons the high roller, one of the reasons I fell out with it so often is, although sometimes it worked, and a few times it worked fine, you know, you could get several runs out of it, you couldn't trust it. It ruins the whole fun of the thing. So I'm not going to bother. No. No way. I'll wait for the aluminium idler gear. So HPI, please hurry up. They said there was no release date as yet, which is a bit crap. What else to say about it? I firmly believe it's going to be a great truck. So I want it, eventually I want it to be hot on the heels of the Proline Pro MT, but for less money. And I am reasonably confident we will get there with that. There just needs to be a little more R&D done by HPI regarding, you know, how it will survive on more powerful systems. I mean HPI are one of the better manufacturers, and like any good manufacturer, they will be doing extensive R&D with the products we release. And I guess that the idler gear will be perfect with the brushed system that came with it, with a nickel metal high drive battery. I didn't use it at all. I wasn't interested in having a brushed monster truck. So I can't report on that, unfortunately. And the one thing I will say that's positive before the video ends is, let me just talk about this for a second. My wheelie bar that you saw in the last video, if you saw the last video regarding my jump shot, it failed straight away. The upper arms weren't strong enough. This is not an HPI part, this is a part that I sort of found lying around, and I sort of made a wheelie bar. It failed, no good. So this is the Swami Ultimate Wheelie Bar, which I had on my high roller. It was actually for the Traxxas Stampede. I've actually had to cut it narrower there. You can see I've had to sort of cut the sides off it near the top because the gearbox housing is narrower on the jump shot than the high roller. But I've used this, and this is absolutely fantastic. Works perfectly. Strong as anything. These won't break. If you're looking for a good wheelie bar for a truck, you mean it's for the Stampede, but as long as you've got skills with a drill, maybe a hacksaw or a Dremel, you can make these fit. So yeah, worth the investment. I really do recommend these Swami bars. I'll put a link up anyway. And that's it. You won't see the jump shot again until it's fixed. But I don't think it'll be take too long. I hope not anyway. So, thanks for watching. I know it was a bit of a sort of downer. Truck's broken. I'm not very well. But what can I do? Anyway, thanks for watching. I'll see you soon. Cheers.